We still got some folks coming. But it's a beautiful day in Elmira. Woo! Hi guys! We're live! Woo! Miss Mackey? Can you take that for me?
Yeah, sure.
Awesome.
Would you guys like a sign?
Sure, thank
you. That's not working.
You're very welcome.
Let's see. Is this gonna be good for everybody? Are you gonna be able to hear me?
Would you like a sign too?
Yes, thank you.
You're very welcome.
Woo!
Would you like a sign?
Thank you.
Yes, please. Thank you. This one's beautiful.
Oh, thanks. You should tell Becca that.
Wait, all right, well, if they come out, tell me to turn it off. I'll
like a sign?
We are here today. Fight poverty and not the poor. Let me hear you say that. We're going to fight poverty.
Not the poor.
Fight poverty.
Fight poverty.
Not the poor.
Woo!
Before New York can become a justice leader, we have to face the reality that we are among the nation's leaders in several measures of injustice. We have the country's worst income inequality, which dramatically worsened over the Great Recession and recovery. And Elmira knows all about that. Even more startling is the number of New Yorkers who can't afford to meet their basic needs. Over half of the New Yorkers, nearly 10 million of us, are poor or low income. This includes 60% of the children and two-thirds of all New Yorkers of color. Only California, Hawaii, and Louisiana have a higher proportion of poor residents of color, and we are the sixth highest when it comes to children in poverty. And that's violence. We're not going to stand for it. We're going to fight poverty.
Fight poverty.
Not the poor. Somebody is hurting my people, and it cannot be allowed to continue. New York's approach to economic development under Governor Cuomo's leadership, offering various taxpayer-funded incentives to private companies, hasn't made a dent in poverty or inequality. It was never meant to. The governor continues to cite the Buffalo Billion as an economic success, despite the fact that poverty in Buffalo has increased since it was first announced.